So, do you reckon I look sporty enough?
Oh, yeah. If eating mince pies counts as a sport.
I can't help it, they're Moorish. Oh, cheer up, Trace.
No, I can't. I'm dreading tomorrow.
Then don't go. Phone in sick.
I've got to go. I promised Mrs. Mims I'd be there to support her. Look, she lives for her, Trevor. How's she going to cope when they take him away?
He might get off.
And I might be Tina Turner. Of course he won't get off. His prints are all over the shooter. He was identified by two different witnesses and his alibi denies ever having met him. It's going to bring back horrible memories of the day Daryl got sent down.
I know. Look, do you want me to keep you company tomorrow? I don't mind going up that court again. I've got quite fond memories of the day Chris got sentenced. In fact, if I had a recording of the judge sending him down, it'd be one of me desert island discs. Come on, let's do it. Get your coat.
I'm not sure I fancy coming. I don't even like tennis.
Who's talking about tennis? The only reason I'm going is to ogle all those muscular thighs and those tight little bums. Look, we promised Dawn we'd support her in the tournament. She said she's gone further this year than she's ever gone before.
Why that hard to believe?
These are my neighbours.
Hi. Dorian's told me all about you. You must lead such exciting lives.
Not really.
I mean, fancy having desperate criminals for husbands. All I've been is a boring old managing director of a large public company.
Wish I had one of those.
You can always take mine off my hands.
Excuse me, but how come you both end up married to rich, dull blokes who pay you no attention, work too hard and will probably drop dead before they're 60?
We've probably just got lucky.
Can I give you a tip, darling?
Must you?
You know why you lost, don't you?
She was blinded by Bruce's boomerang?
It's a racket, darling. The strings aren't tight enough.
Well, you're the ideal person to increase my attention.
Last season's model, you see. If you care about your game, it's no good settling for second best, darling. Well, I must go and have a quick shower.
Make sure you don't melt, wicked witch of the West.
Oh, have a look, Trace. I could get really silly over him. Or under him, his choice.
Hard luck, Dorian. You really should do some work on your ground strokes.
And your serve. And your volley.
Still on for a double session tomorrow?
Of course.
Beats me where you fit in any tennis.
Me and Bruce, you must be joking.
I thought that's why you joined this place, so you could get off with the coaches.
I may have had an odd moment with one or two.
Dozen.
But they've all got to be able to have an intellectual discussion afterwards. Who are you trying to kid?
Look, I prefer not to get involved with coaches anymore, all right?
Why?
I choose not to talk about it.
Yeah, like Michael Jackson chooses not to mess around with a face God gave him.
Go on. Who was he?
His name was Ernesto.
Sounds like Spanish premium bonds.
He come up for you.
Ernesto was cultured and gorgeous. And he was the best tennis coach I ever had. Or didn't have, if you know what I mean.
Oh, he played for the other side.
Oh, no, he was all man, just devoted to his wife.
Spoil sport.
We did become firm friends. He did a lot of work on my grip.
So it weren't a complete waste of time?
It ended sadly, though. Ernesto had to go back to his own country, and before he went, he asked me to invest $10,000 in a business venture.
What, so you lent it to him and he ripped you off, Wally?
Oh, no, I didn't lend him the money. You shouldn't lend money to friends, Sharon. It can damage the relationship. Instead, I bought him a very expensive watch as a bon voyage gift. And I said, if you value money more than the memory of our friendship, then sell the watch.
And did he?
The next day.
You
two go off home. I'll be all right. Well, don't be daft. We said we'd be here. And anyway, the jury will be back any minute.
Not necessarily, Trace. I mean, did you get a good gander at them? Half of them look as if they ain't got two pennies to rub together.
So?
My guess is they'll prolong their deliberations so they get the free overnight at some Novotel. Plus a chance to half-inch the complimentary share cap.
Yeah, well, that's good to know, isn't it? I mean, the longer they take, the more undecided they must be.
Please, Tracy, I'm not simple. Don't pasteurise me.
It's a terrible stink in here all of a sudden.
Oh, I'm sorry, girls. It's the waiting's upset me stomach.
You?
And it's getting stronger.
Yeah, I've noticed it too. What's the order of rubbish they leave lying around in here? Talking of rubbish, how are you coping, ladies?
Why don't you go and screw yourself?
Still married, are you? Or have you had the sense to cut your losses and leave them to rot?
Look, we don't have to take this from you. We're just here to support a mate, all right?
Yeah? Funny how your mates are villains, though.
My Trevor's innocent till proven guilty.
Which is just about to happen. The jury's back. And another one bites the dust, eh? Oh, yeah, innocent, yes. Well, that's what the jury said, wasn't it?
I never thought I'd get him home for Christmas. Oh, isn't it wonderful, Tracy?
Yeah.
Oh,
I'm really pleased for you. Oh. Here, can you smell that stink again?
So, what's happened to Tatum, then?
I suppose he went back to the Nick to lick his wounds.
What? Still on duty, is he?
How should I know?
Blimey, Sharon, you're a bit slow today.
Takes one to know one.
Look, the jury just said they preferred the word of Trevor the Ted to Tatum the DI, pillar of the community.
So, these days the police would be hard-pressed to get a conviction against Jack the Ripper. Even if he was standing in the dock with a carving knife in one hand and a tart sliver in the other.
So what does that tell you?
It tells me not to have the mixed grill for lunch.
Yeah, well, it tells me there's a very fair chance that Detective Inspector Tatum is now under a bit of a cloud.
What a night, eh, girls?
Yeah, brilliant.
This one goes a bit, doesn't it?
Oh, you sussed that already, have you?
My jive technique.
Shame your lads can't be here.
Yeah.
Never thought I'd be here tonight.
Neither did I.
Enjoying yourself, though, ain't you, girl?
Well, yes, I think I am. Didn't think I would. Girls had to drag me here, kicking and screaming.
Until we told her there'd be five blokes for every woman.
Then she drove through three red lights.
Here, what about you?
Thanks, I'm waiting for
me
husband. You go,
Sharon. No, thanks. Want a bloke, not a joke. Blimey, I know Tatum's put away a few in his time, but look at you!
Well, if you can't get smashed out of your head on a night like this, what's the point, eh? I mean, Trevor's got off, all his friends are here. And to cap it all, I've just heard that Tatum's been suspended.
Who told you?
Bloke behind the bar's brother's a traffic warden. I think I'll buy him a truck.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I've got two bits of brilliant news. First, that scumbag Tatum's been suspended. Yes! Second, I hereby declare a campaign to free my husband and brother-in-law, who are both languishing in prison as a result of an earlier fit-up of Tatum's. Yes. Yes. So, the campaign is going to be Free the Chick Will Too!
Yes!
What's
you? Wouldn't Trevor show you his tattoo?
Yeah, you didn't say a word on the drive home.
Oh, I know why she's got the hump. Because she had to give us a lift and she wanted to be off getting her leg over Trevor Suzuki. Anyway, here's a toast to the Chigwell 2, innocent men victimised by a malicious pig.
Cheers. Yes, well, they're not innocent, are they, Tracy? They're guilty. They're still armed robbers. You know they are.
Not necessarily. If the jury at their trial had known that Tatum was bent, our husbands could have walked.
Yes, straight into the nearest Bradford and Bingley to demand money with menaces.
What Tracy's trying to say, Dor, is this Tatum business introduces what the lawyers call an element of reasonable doubt.
No, it doesn't. It introduces what my mother calls an element of outrageous chutzpah. They're still guilty men.
I know why she's got the hump. Because we called them the Chigwell too, and she thinks it's going to affect property prices.
Well, it's not going to help, is it?
Look, we don't mind calling them the Edmonton two.
Or the Leytonstone two.
Or the Leabridge Road two.
Or the Oxton two.
Oh, you just don't understand, do you? Suddenly I see that we are standing on opposite sides of a social chasm. Can you not perceive the moral bankruptcy inherent in your opportunist seizing upon Trevor Mim's absurd good fortune in order to campaign for the release of two dangerous felons?
You can see who's on the mineral water tonight.
Now, look at Orion. If your husband was banged up, wouldn't you do whatever you could to get him out? Even if there was a teensy doubt that he might have done something a little bit out of order?
Tracy, that hypothetical situation is never going to arise because, firstly, my husband is a law-abiding stalwart of this community.
And secondly, you wouldn't give a toss if he was banged up anyway. It'd just give you more strumping time.
Hang on. Let's not fall out, eh? If Dorian don't want to get involved in a campaign, why don't we just agree to differ?
Fine.
I don't want to agree to differ. This campaign is the most important thing that's happened to me since the day Daryl got sent down. And if she don't want to lift one over-manicured talent to help, she can just sod off right out of my life. Are you sure there's a G in campaign?
Trust me, Mum.
Oh, I don't know. It looks a bit amateurish.
Oh, thanks a bunch.
I won't criticise him.
No? I'll get it. Probably the Home Secretary come round with a pardon.
Mum's Trevs.
How's it going, Trace?
Oh, slowly. But I suppose once we get all these posters up...
What, these? No offence, son. All very colourful and that. Bit Blue Peter, though, innit, eh?
Can you do better?
Me, no. But I got a mate in the print.
Trevor, they're brilliant.
Well, I'm glad you say that. So I took the liberty of having a couple of thousand run off, all right?
Nah.
And I've got a mate, listen, in the T-shirt game, eh?
Trevor, we've only got a couple of £100 left in the kitty.
My treat? My way of saying thanks for looking after my mum while I was out of circulation. Here. Badges. Hey.
Oh, Trevor.
Hey.
I think I'll have that one.
Certainly, madam. An excellent choice.
And could you have my husband's initials put on it?
If you wish, madam.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
And could you show me that one? How much is this?
£150, including the presentation case. Would you like to try it?
No. I'll have five.
Five?
There's Roland, Bruce, Jerry, Alan, and Kurt.
Oh, I was forgetting Kurt.
If I may be so bold, Madam doesn't seem old enough to have five sons.
They're her lovers.
Well, most of them.
Since when did they do a platinum card?
It's not on general release yet. Well, That's my Christmas shopping.
Is anything the matter?
I'm afraid we don't seem to be able to get a sanction on your card, madam. Perhaps if you have another?
Well, of course I have another.
The trials and tribulations of using a high street bank.
Which one should I try first, madam?
Well, I don't know. There should be funds in all of them. Unless, of course, my husband forgot to pay last month's account before he flew off to Sicily. In which case, it's his own fault if I can't buy his stupid Christmas present.
Don't you find all this rather humiliating?
No, I'm savouring every moment.
No luck with this one, madam. But never fear, two more to go.
I'll kill Marcus. I will. Do you know, I almost wish we were still having conjugal relations just so I could withdraw them.
Perhaps the madam would like to take a seat while you're waiting.
Hello.
Look, I'm not in the mood.
You are Mrs. Dorian Green.
Of course I am. How do you know?
Detective Sergeant Bloomfield. Could you spare me 5 minutes?
I've been here for over an hour.
Marcus has been here all night.
What? Oh, no. Don't tell me he's been DPPing on the back of King's Cross Station.
I don't know what he's been doing. He decided to come home a day early. They arrested him at Heathrow and brought him here.
Why?
Well, I don't know. He doesn't know. He says he doesn't think it's because he had 25 extra panatellas in his overnight bag. Oh, God, this is a nightmare.
Must be something big if they've frozen all your credit cards.
I know. It's awful. You won't tell anyone, will you? Promise me.
Of course I won't tell anyone. Are you going to be at the tennis club tonight?
Oh, yes, I'm just in the mood. Why?
Just wondered. Let me treat you to lunch.
Just wondered? You can't wait to spread it round, can you? What are you going to do? Have it announced over the tannoy? Fourth wanted for mixed doubles, and have you heard about Dorian Green's husband?
Why are you getting yourself so upset, darling? Whenever Marcus is around, you just complain he cramps your style. Now he's out of your way for a few days. Or years, maybe. Cheer up.
Was a successful businessman. He had no need to turn to crime. He was voted Eastern County's Conservatory Rector of the Year 3 years running.
Don't go over the top, Trace.
All right, 2 years running. And then he was framed.
I see. But is this news anymore? I mean, we've had allegations against the police with the Birmingham Six, the Guildford Four, the Tottenham Three. Don't you think the public have had enough?
Look, I listen to the radio quite a bit. I don't think I've ever heard you on it.
Really?
But then I suppose you're just starting out, aren't you? All journalists got to start somewhere. Then it's just a matter of recognising a big story when you see one.
Yeah, like in that Watergate film. I mean, if Dustin Hoffman and Robert Redford had just said, a little burglary, big deal.
But they dug. And they investigated. And they brought down the President of the United States.
But that was just a film.
What are you talking about? Really happened?
Are you sure?
Excuse me.
I'm sorry.
Are you saying you really think this is a big story?
Huge, Sam. Huge. political undercurrents we can only imagine. And I'll tell you something for nothing. When the boys get out and get their apology from the Queen, and all Fleet Street are clamouring for their interviews, we'll say no. They're exclusive to our mate Sam, who campaigned alongside us.
Because it's not just Daryl and Chris. There's an epidemic of framing going on in this country. No one's safe.
Chad, Tracy, you've got to help me. Marcus has been arrested.
See? I told you.
He's been arrested and I don't know why. They let me in to see him and I said, was it anything to do with when you were working for the Daily Mirror Pension Fund? She went white and muttered something about the cell being bugged.
Your husband was involved with Robert Maxwell.
What's he got to do with you?
They used to bump into each other at do's.
If this checks out, I could get you on television.
That was brilliant, Dor. Talk about timing.
What are you talking about? It's true.
It ain't, is it?
Sharon, what's going to happen to him?
I don't know. Depends on what he's done.
Well, he hasn't done anything.
Well, then he'll be all right.
Oh, yeah. Like our blokes are all right.
Our blokes did do something, Trace.
Only according to that scumbag Tatum.
You've completely brainwashed yourself, haven't you?
Don't ignore me. I'm in a state of shock. Where's my cup of hot sweet tea?
Sorry, Dor.
I don't know what to do. Marcus has been arrested. All my credit cards have been frozen. Melanie Fishman can't wait to tell everyone.
Well, fair dues. He's locked up. He must be guilty.
No!
Lay off, Trace. Can't you see she's in a state?
I don't know what to do. What am I going to do?
You're a silly mare, Dor. We'll look after you. We won't let her starve, will we, Shell?
Of course not. Here, I'll reheat the last portion of black pudding for you, eh?
So, how are you bearing up?
OK. The screws are all a bit umpy about the campaign, though.
Game.
Sorry, love. Prison Officers Association declared a ban on passive smoking.
What about all the others?
Oh, right. See what I mean?
Right. So, say I earned 20 grand in my last year liberty.
Did you? What happened to it then? I suppose you put it on a horse that did a wrong turning at Beecher's Brook and it's still trying to hitch a ride back to Newmarket.
I had an unlucky streak.
I had an unlucky Greek.
Anyhow, 4 years' wages equals how much?
4 twenties are 80, Chris.
You sure? You don't want to check it on a calculator?
No, so far I'm coping.
Right, well, double it for inflation. Right, double it again for loss of liberty. Right, how much is that?
320,000.
320 grand? Blimey. I'm a millionaire.
Just calm down, Chris. Don't get ahead of yourself.
Oh, I can't help it. So exciting. What's happening? I never thought I'd end up on the front of a T-shirt. Good old Trev.
Yeah. Don't know where he's getting the money from, though. He ain't working.
Sharon, he just did the Halifax for 25 grand, which he probably won't have to pay tax on.
He got acquitted. You're not saying he really done it, are you?
Of course he done it. That's his job. Well, he's on the outside and we're on the inside. So, he's got a bit of dosh. Plus, he's probably got a guilty conscience.
Why?
Well, because he never helped you and Tracy out before, of course.
Well, why should he have?
Look, if I tell you, you promise not to tell Tracy?
Of course not.
Tell me.
Well, I suppose he wanted to keep the little woman in the dark. He's your old-fashioned sort of villain.
He's not a villain.
Oh, no. Is that why we come to Maidstone Nick once a fortnight? Because it's such a pretty ride.
That's why Trevor's being so helpful.
Too true. According to Chris, Trevor's share of their Newport Pagnell job was at least 75 grand. I mean, by rights, he should have been helping you and me out since the boys got sent down. It's the code, isn't it?
Yeah, well, better late than never, eh?
Mind you, that's assuming the boys did do the heist. According to you, they didn't.
I didn't say Chris didn't.
Is this your car, madam?
Yeah, why?
Look at your tyre.
Oh, no. What are you doing?
It is an offence to be in charge of a vehicle on the public highway with incorrectly inflated tyres.
Oh, it's a flight!
Exactly. You can't get much more incorrectly inflated than that, can you?
Hello?
saying is maybe Chris planned the whole thing with Trevor. They all probably didn't know nothing about it. He just thought they was going off to survey a conservatory or something.
Get real, Trace. Daryl planned the Newport Pagnell job and you know it. They were caught bang to rights. I mean, did Tatum put the guns in the car?
Might have done.
This whole campaign's doing your head in, girl. You want your bumps feeling.
Oh, you're just writing that Chris will get out and you'll have to knuckle down and make something of your marriage.
Yeah, a horror movie.
Hello, it's Dorian at midday. I knocked but no answer. Are you in? Captain 15. Where are you? Tracy, Sharon, anyone there? Yesterday you promised to be there for me. Why aren't you?
Dorian called.
Silly cow.
Ark, who's talking?
Mrs. Stubbs, this is Michael Tiddy from the Kilroy programme. We're doing an edition on miscarriages of justice tomorrow. Are you available? Please call me on 081-943-1780.
Fantastic! National television!
Don't do it, Trace.
You are joking.
Look, you're already getting police harassment.
Yeah, and I'll tell the nation about it on nationwide television.
But Tracy...
Oh, you're just jealous because you've always wanted to get on Kilroy.
But I didn't mean the programme.
And now on BBC One, Kilroy.
Oh, bum!
Taped over dirty dancing.
Hello and good morning. Miscarriages of justice, are they increasing and what can we do about them? And what impact do they have on confidence in our police? Tracy Stubbs, you're running this campaign to free the Chigwell too. Why have you started it 4 years after your husband was imprisoned?
Well, Robert, I always knew that my husband never did it, but we only recently learned that the detective in charge of the case was Bent.
Hey, watch this, it might be libelous, be careful.
I don't care. My husband's languishing for a crime he didn't commit.
Well, look, as an ex-copper, I'm fed up with people like you always slagging off the police.
Maybe one of your loved ones banged up.
If I could just say, Robert, speaking as a solicitor, I feel a problem that we must address is the length of time it takes for injustice to be undone. I mean, look how long people like Judith Ward and the Birmingham Six had to wait.
Hear, hear. The Home Secretary's got a grant bail pending
and
up here.
I was phoning and phoning. Where were you?
When he's too old.
Tracy's on television.
You know, being husband.
Oh, Shane, is she? Good job I've got a tape in. Good. What'd you do that for?
Don't you want to know where I was last night?
Not a lot.
I couldn't go to my mother's. I wouldn't go to that bitch Melanie Fishman's. Couldn't afford to book into a hotel. So I had to spend the night in the spare room of my pathetic brother's pathetic semi and pathetic Collindale. The baby screaming in the next room and the pervasive smell of regurgitated baby milk seeping from every wall.
So it's not going to make the good hotel guide then? Oh, all right, Dor. Why couldn't you stay in your own house?
Because the police have sealed it off.
Hey, why?
Apparently, they found $100,000 in Marcus's bank account originating in Bolivia.
So? That's your access bill for a month taken care of.
Sharon, Bolivia is in South America.
Yeah?
They've charged him with drug running! I mean, it's so ridiculous! The only drug he's interested in is milk of magnesia!
Hey, why don't you just tell him where the money come from?
He can't! Or he won't.
Oh. Here, Dor. You don't think he really could be...
A big-time drug baron? Don't you think I'd know?
Why? He doesn't know you're a big-time adulteress, does he?
Stubbs.
Oh, hello.
Rodney Smithson.
I know. Thanks for sticking up for me in there.
Oh, not at all. I thought you were very eloquent.
Do you mean it, or are you just trying to give me a tug?
Hardly, Mrs. Stubbs. I live with a conveyancing clerk called Gregory.
Oh.
It's Exactly. However, that is not why I should like to meet your husband and Mr. Theodopoulopoulos. I think that a gross miscarriage of justice has been perpetrated, and I'd like to help them.
But why don't it cost me an arm and a leg?
Mr. Stubbs, if we get them off, there'll be so much compensation, you won't miss an arm and two legs.
Hello, Tracy. Been mouthing off on the telly now, have you?
Yeah, just see me.
I've got a weak stomach.
Then let me introduce you. This is Mr. Tate. He's harassing me. This is Rodney Smithson, my solicitor. Now, what was he wanting to tell me?
Oh, I just heard on the grapevine your son's been arrested for illegal fly posting.
Stubbs, if I can be of any help, please don't hesitate to call.
Thank you.
Oh, pup. I hope you're going to wipe that off after.
Where have you been? Negotiating a series?
I've been down Waltham Stone Nick.
Oh, you weren't that bad.
Garfy was arrested, weren't he?
I was just pasting as seen on TV stickers on the Chigwell 2 posters, and this police van screeched up and four coppers jumped out.
Mr. Smithson's putting in an official complaint.
Who?
The brief that was on Kilroy with me.
Oh, the one you were making eyes at.
No, I wasn't. It was the camera angles.
Anyway, he was brilliant. Got me out in no time. And he gave the station officer a really vicious bollocking without using a single rude word.
And he's doing all this for free, is he, Trace?
Never mind the money. I want to see myself on telly. Come on.
I've rewound it for you.
Now, you may be wondering what I'm doing.
I hope you ain't wiped over dirty dancing.
Only the beginning.
1900.
You've blown it, Shell. The first and last time I'm ever likely to be on television and you so press the wrong bloody button.
Maybe Daryl taped it.
I mean, we were both stunned when the gun suddenly appeared from nowhere. Weren't we, Daryl?
Gobsmacked.
Although your fingerprints were on them.
Yeah, because Tatum tossed a gun at me and I automatically caught it, thereby transferring my dabs onto said firearm.
But, Mr. Theodopoulopoulos, your fingerprints were found on money from the robbery that was used to place a bet at a bookmaker's a few miles from the scene of the crime.
Of course. Because we went up to Newport Pagnell to get some money off a geezer we'd done a conservatory for cash, didn't we, Dabble?
Yeah. I realise now he must have done the blag and used the money to pay us. I mean, if it means sticking our hands up to a charge of tax evasion, so be it.
So be it.
And can you remember where you built this conservatory for this mystery man?
Yeah, I do as it happens. It was a restaurant just outside of Milton Keynes, but it burnt down a couple of years ago and the owner disappeared.
Well, he would have, wouldn't he? If he was bent, eh?
Good. Well, that all seems very plausible. I think we're on our way, gentlemen. Oh,
great. Great, isn't it, Trace?
Yeah, I suppose.
You don't sound too happy.
Well, of course I'm happy. But you didn't do it, did you, Daryl? Tatum did set you up.
I believe we can convince the appeal court of that.
That ain't what I'm talking about. Look, did you do it or didn't you?
Tracy.
Listen, it's not a matter of what we did, Trace.
Exactly. We're talking here of reasonable doubt. We can establish that and have an excellent opportunity to overturn the conviction and extract a very satisfying sum of money from the Crown.
And finish Tatum's career for good. Eh, Daryl?
Yeah. The icing on the cake, eh, sugar? He deserves it. I mean, arresting my Garfield, that's right out of order. Of course, you'll have to give your sister her marching orders. But Chris says he's keen to have another go at married life.
Yeah, hang about, Del. I might have said that and there was no chance of getting out.
You did do it, didn't you?
Mrs. Stubbs, this is a conversation I don't even want to know about.
Look, I need to know.
Tracy, you've done great in this campaign and I love you for it. There's no need to start believing your own publicity, is there?
Yeah, and I mean, we promise not to do it again, don't we, eh?
He did it, Shell. Eh? They all did it. And Chris. They're both as guilty as sin.
Bad visit.
Men are all the same, Tracy. They have criminal propensities they cannot control.
Shut up, Dor. Been so stupid trying to convince myself that Daryl's innocent.
Oh, no. But if you really want to believe something...
And that solicitor's only in it for the money.
Welcome to the real world, Tracy.
Does it matter? As long as he can get them out.
Well, it shouldn't matter, but it does. I mean, if they did it, that probably means Trevor's a villain too.
You're a regular Miss Marples, aren't you?
Which means Tatum probably ain't been.
Look, don't feel too bad. He's still a bastard, isn't he?
I think the bottom line, Tracy, is all men are irredeemably flawed.
Yeah. They're only good for one thing. Then they fall asleep. I'm so depressed.
Join the club.
What a good idea, Dor.
I mean, if Daryl does get out, the police will be on his back every minute of the day.
Oh, snap out of it, Trace. Look at that bum. Should have a health warning on it.
Think of nothing but sex.
Yes, usually. But now I have to do your thinking about it as well as my own.
Daryl will be so depressed when he realises the game's up.
Dorian!
Darling!
Oh! Melanie. Oh, you look fabulous. New tracksuit.
Cheruti.
Gesundheit.
I'm so surprised to see you here, Dorian. You're so brave. We've all heard how the police have sealed off your house while Marcus is under suspicion of laundering money for Oblivion Drug Cartel.
Louder, Melanie. I don't think they can hear you in the showers.
That's a sweet dress.
I borrowed her that.
Really? It's wonderful how Richard shops can manufacture a copy of a Paris original that almost convinces.
Were you born a vicious tart, or do you have coaching?
We must speak to the management about tightening up the criteria for bringing in guests.
If you don't shut it, you'll be talking to your doctor about another nose job.
Good God, it's Ernesto!
Oh, thanks a bundle, Dorian.
How fortunate polyester's machine washable.
Who's Ernesto?
The Spanish coach. The one who sold my watch.
Oh, yeah, the one you couldn't get into bed.
Couldn't you? You missed something.
Very exciting day for you both. Justin, do you know this takes your earnings for the year to $2 million?
Pues yo no sé qué puedo decir. Yo he trabajado por eso toda mi vida y hoy lo tengo. Y no sé qué puedo decir. Solamente gracias para todo. Gracias. Sí.
This is a wonderful day. And we very much want to thank our friends in England who invested money and hope in my sister's career while she was still on the junior circuit.
Oh, well, I hope you'll pay them all back.
We already have. Our investors have been sent checks which will repay their money tenfold.
What's 10 times $10,000, Trace?
$100,000, Shell.
And where does Ernesto live?
South America. The continent in which I think Bolivia is to be found.
Right, Dor, you get in the vintage champagne and we won't tell Marcus that you had him written off as the Chigwell connection.
Oh, what a relief. Right, I'm going to go and tell the police, get the house opened up and get out of this viscose frock.
He was following us.
You're hallucinating, Trace. I told you not to take those last half dozen tranks. Look, will you stop harassing my sister or we'll report you?
Me? Harassing? I'm not even on active service.
Look, surely a private citizen can pull up in his car and say hello to the wife of a notorious blagger that he once put away.
Yeah, well, they ain't going to be away for much longer, so there'd be a nice little cell in Maidstone vacant, just right for a bent copper. And another thing...
I'm sorry to spoil your Christmas, but it's not going to be a vacancy. In fact, there's likely to be a sudden outbreak of overcrowding once the old firm gets reunited.
What are you on about?
I'm on about a certain Trevor Mims, who yesterday ran out of a North London jeweller's with a gun in one hand and a bag of Tom in the other.
You liar! Trevor was in Amsterdam yesterday.
No, not Amsterdam. Amstead, High Street. Breaks my heart too. He's such a love.
Well, all right. So the silly sod got himself nicked. That doesn't mean you didn't set him up first time round.
No. I think I might get the benefit of the doubt. Especially as Trevor kindly gave me a brown envelope.
What's a brown envelope?
A brown envelope is when a suspect, in this case Trevor, tells the police everything he can about every crime he's ever committed in exchange for a promise of a lighter sentence.
You mean grassing?
Yeah, I mean super grassing, Trace.
After all I did for his mum.
Yeah. Looks like I'll just have to knuckle down and do me time after all.
Oh, Darryl.
Still, we give them a ramp of their money, eh? Once or twice, I even thought you might get us out.
Only once or twice?
Well, after all, we did do it, sugar. Smith knew I was fannying him. These dodgy briefs all know the score.
But you lied to me. I made a complete fool of myself on Kilroy in front of everyone.
Trace, Tracy, look. It never crossed my mind you were taking me serious.
But you just stood up in that appeal court and denied you was ever at Newport, Pagnell.
I told the court I was the rightful heir to the Russian throne. If they get me out of this hole, I'm back home with you. That's what I want. That's what keeps me going. Especially this near Christmas. Oh, I'm sorry, sugar. I suppose I just forgot how deep down honest you've always been.
You mean gullible?
Don't sound so hurt.
I'm frightened, Darryl. I'm frightened that when you get out, you'll just go back to it like Trevor did. I mean, he got off for something he did do, and a fortnight later he's out terrorising engaged couples with a starting pistol.
But I'm different to Trevor.
Yeah.
Yeah. For starters, I'm not a prat. When I come out, that's it. I'm not going back inside again, promise.
Not every con says that. Just means he don't ever intend getting caught again.
What do you want me to do? Swear?
Yeah. I want you to swear that when you get out, you own as much as fiddle your bus fares.
All right. I swear.
Good.
How about the tube?
Garth, any chance of getting your bum down here before the Queen's speech starts?
Hark the herald angels sing, I can't stop this blooming thing.
I don't know why you're bothering.
Because it's Christmas, Trace, that's why. Look, Darryl wouldn't want you moping around. Like he said, we gave the system a run for its money. Anyway, it could be worse.
Explain how.
You could be in hospital getting visited by Noel Edmonds. You get it, Trace. I'm in the middle of a very delicate operation. Begging for it.
Someone's left a card and legged it. It's from Trevor. What's this? Another one of these brown envelopes.
Ooh. You'd think you know there are two R's in sorry, wouldn't you?
Sure.
Who said there ain't a Santa Claus?
I don't know why you're getting so excited, just because some toe rag coughs up a little bit of what he owes us anyway.
That's it, Trace. Really getting into the festive spirit now, ain't ya? Come on, let's count it!
I just had to tell you the good news. Marcus is free, my credit cards are once again acceptable in the best parts of Bond Street, and Melanie Fishman has the most enormous cold sore on her upper lip.
And a Merry Christmas to you too, Dor.
So you're the reason for that news item on the last minute upsurge in the retail trade?
I certainly hope so. Here you are. Wear them in good health.
For us?
Of course. You're my best friends. I love you.
And you're all right too. For a neurotic, shopaholic sex maniac.
Well, go on then, open them. Let me feast my eyes upon your grateful faces. I know. You're lost for words. May I suggest, you shouldn't have Dorian. They're beautiful. We're not worth it.
Dor, they're beautiful!
Oh, not half. Trouble is, what have I got to go with something like this?
Well, just have to treat yourself to something new, wouldn't you? Whee!
I'll get it, Trace. They say good things come in threes. It might be Mel Gibson with a case of the rampant ots. This is a surprise. Tidied up, have you, Trace? Honey, we've got an unexpected visitor.
Merry Christmas.
Right, that's it. I'm phoning the National Council for taking liberties.
Now, Tracy, that's not the attitude. I've simply come in the spirit of the season to say Merry Christmas and no hard feelings. So, here's your ticket for that flat tyre. And here's a bottle of brandy to get your pudding blazing.
Ooh! Must be staff bonuses all round every time you walk into Thresher's.
I'd offer you a nip, only I can't find me pliers.
Very droll, Tracy. Well, I must be off to church.
Why? To frame the vicar?
Tracy, please, let bygones be bygones, eh? How come there's a £50 note stuck to the sole of my shoe?
Must be your lucky day.
You must have brought it in with you. Anyway, don't spend it all at once. I'll see you out. Well, I wish you Merry Christmas and a couple of dozen Happy New Years. Because if I never see you again, it'll be once too often.
Don't be like that, Tracy. Look, you might be married to a villain, but you're OK. What you tried to do for him, it was more than he deserved.
No, it wasn't. He's my husband. Nothing's too much for him.
You're wasted on him, you know. Look, if you fancy going out for a drink or a curry one night...
You must be out of your Christmas tree.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Here, you better have this. You probably need it more than me.
No, thanks. I'm not at the stage where I need to take 50 quid off the bottom of copper shoes.
Suit yourself.
Cheeky's got asking me out.
He never.
He did. Sent him on his way.
No, you're brilliant. I've looked everywhere. Still can't find where you stashed the loot.
Yeah, well, didn't want him to find it, did I?
No, I reckon you got a little bit of your Daryl in you.
I wish I had.
Right, I've bung the turkey in the oven. Let's crack open the sherry.
Yeah. What? Ah! Oh!
What do I do when you are far away and I am blue? What'll I do
when I'm alone?